But we were just wondering if maybe we could have an interview with maybe you, because we know that you're really involved in CPS and also. Well, thank you, Ms. Massey. Sounds good. Thank you. Have a nice day.
And we're trying to raise awareness towards different social justice programs that are active throughout the valley. And we're trying to raise awareness over the goodness that comes through CPS.
Sure. So we are a state agency, so it's considered like a government agency. And we actually, we work, of course, we protect children that are being abused or neglected of any kind. And I can explain to you the different categories of abuse or neglect, because there's all kinds. And then if they've determined that there's some kind of abuse or neglect, then what they do is they intervene. And depending on what they find, an intake is received, an investigation is done, and then depending on the investigation will depend on what happens to the case. Okay. If they don't find anything, they rule out and close it. If they find something, then depending on what they find, if they need to go into foster care, if they need to be transferred to family based.
We want to know, when you walk into your office every year, like, what is your goal? What is your motive?
Of course, it's always to ensure that, you know, all the kids are safe. I always pray and hope that it is a good day. And what I mean by a good day is that kids are safe. Because a lot of stuff happens. Life is life. And so, of course, you know, especially when you see that call at a certain time of the day, and you're just like, what happened? You know, because you know why they're calling you, you know. I'd say a good day is when I guess a good day for CPS is always when you don't have a report or anything of abuse or neglect going on, you know. But that's what we do.
Yeah. Obviously, you've been here for many years. You've been working at the same job for many years. What's kept you doing the same thing? Because I know it's not easy seeing, you know, the constant abuse, children being abused, and I know it's not an easy job at all. So what's kept you here?
I like it. I think you have to like it. You have to like helping and working with people. And you have to like change also, because we change. We change a lot. There's constant change with the agency. And so, and it's very interesting. It's exciting. It's never boring. And that's what's kept me here. It's, you know, it is very fast paced. You know, you'll never be bored. Ever. I promise you. You know, and it is exciting. You know, and it's interesting. And I like to hear, like, when you meet with families and stuff, their story. I mean, everybody has a story to tell. And just to kind of help them and build on their strengths. You know, you have to kind of be interested in that. And want to help these people. Because you actually see, the things that you see, you're just kind of like, oh, you know, the stuff that we walk into.
Would you be able to, like, share with us maybe, like, a really heartbreaking, like,
thing that's ever happened, or like a case.
Something that stuck to you.
Yeah.
It's all our cases are kind of heartbreaking because it's sad. But I do remember when I was a worker, my first removal. You'll always remember your first removal, which is when you had to take the children into foster care. It was actually like six boys, and there were six small boys. They were actually in a, they were living in a trailer up in the Laguna Heights area, and it was cold, and it had no windows, it was open, it had no food. I don't even understand how they were even living there. Mom had left to Mexico and couldn't find anybody, you know. They were hungry, they were starving. We didn't have anybody to, we didn't know any family, you know, to contact. And they took it hard because they wanted to stay there. They didn't want to be taken.
It was a home.
Regardless, there was no food, there was, you know, it was trashed. I mean, it was nasty. You know, it was infested with roaches and rats, and there was no food. They were sleeping on the floor. You know, it was cold. They didn't have any clothes. And that was hard, you know. And so you'll always remember that because it just breaks your heart. And, you know, so I think a couple of the younger ones did get adopted, but the older ones didn't. And I have run into a couple, and they do remember me. And they talk about that, you know, like now they're in a good home and they're taken care of. I mean, they're actually in sports now. And they saw me as a person that actually took them away, you know. And I just kind of like, you know, I was like, yeah, but I know why. I understand, you know. And yeah, you're doing your job, you know. And thanks to you, you know, I'm where I'm at now, you know. But it does move you, you know. And it is hard. And it's hard to hold back your feelings, you know, because when you see these kids and they're crying and they're, you know, and they just, you know, their mom and their dad, and just, you know, it's very hard. It's very hard.
Yeah. Oh, okay, well, this isn't a statistic that you can bring up on the computer or anything, but we just want to know, like, what do you believe is the success rate for the kids that your organization takes in? You know?
But define change.
Define change.
Progress. So define that, you know, because a lot of people, you know, they strive for that perfection. You know, does it even exist? So sometimes, you know, just progress and change, even if it's just a little bit, is a good thing. Because, you know, sometimes that's all that they can do, you know. And then some can just, woo, a big turnaround. It's like, wow. There is a lot. There is progress and there is change. It just depends on how you see it.
Yeah.
Okay. And for some people, they have the ability to make, you know, to make big changes. And for some, this is as good as it's going to get. You know, that's just the way it's going to be. I think that any kind of progress or change moving towards something better is a good thing. And even if it's just educating them and helping them to understand because they didn't get it before, you know, that kind of thing. And then again, it just depends on what kind of change do you want to see. They are going to fall back, but it's about getting back up, you know, and trying to stay sober. So, you know, I think we do see a lot of change, okay? It's not always where we want it to be. You know, but it is progress and change. Mm-hmm. I depend on my workers' skills to be able to determine that. Mm-hmm. You have to be able to determine that. You have to see the family, not you, see the family. Because it's real hard for people not to impose their own personal values. And, you know, so, and just kind of setting back and working with them at their pace with their knowledge. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Thank you.